Hey there.
Hey y'all, it's Kimyetta from Kimyetta Connects, and I know this setting is a little bit different for today's video. Normally you only hear my voice on my prayer videos, or you might see me in my home office study, but I just had to get out the house. Of course, right now we are in the middle of the coronavirus, the pandemic, the quarantine, and I needed to run to the store to grab some things that we needed. And on my way home, the Lord just led me to stop right here. I showed y'all in the beginning. Let me just try to pan my phone so you can see again. And I'm in the parking lot of Piedmont Fayette Hospital, which is very close to my home. And as I was driving home, the Lord just placed it on my heart to just come and sit and cry out and travail and pray for the people in this hospital and other hospitals. It wasn't just about praying for Piedmont Fayette, but, you know, to pray for Northside and Grady and Wellstar system, like all the hospitals, all the workers. I have, of course, a prayer video praying for medical staff, but I believe he placed it on my heart to just come and make this a place as a point of contact to pray. When I pulled in, y'all, there's a big blinking sign that tells you right away that there are no visitors allowed in the hospital as of 3:23. And my heart just ached thinking about that, because I was thinking like, okay, wait a minute. What if, you know, you have an issue with your kid and your kid's got to be in the hospital, heaven forbid, that's not even COVID-19 related, or, you know, or a close relative. The other night, my, about 4 or 5 days ago, my oldest son, he brought me his inhaler. He is being healed of asthma right now, his whole life, and he is at the very end of it. Hallelujah. And he brought me his albuterol inhaler. And, you know, some boys, I ain't gonna discriminate, but you have some boys that won't tell you things ahead of time, like, well, mom, I'm getting low on my medicine. So he didn't. He just came in and said, it's zero left, and just threw it on the counter. And I was like, okay, I gotta call in a prescription. Called in a prescription. And so in between that time, he was outside playing and playing and playing and stuff with his brother, and was kind of out of breath that night. And then the pollen and the allergies, and he was struggling a little bit, maybe about 2 or 3 nights ago. He was just struggling. And I was like, oh my God. And the thought occurred to me, like, I might have to take him to the hospital. But right now, it's not recommended that you go to an emergency room. But if I didn't have any medicine for him, his lungs, you know, being an asthma patient, his lungs, they used to do this a lot. But now that he's big and strong, they don't do this as much. But he was struggling to breathe a little bit. And I prayed, and I was like, God, I don't want to have to take him to the emergency room. I don't want to have to deal with all this COVID stuff, but I want to be safe. So I prayed, my husband and I prayed, and the Holy Spirit placed it on my heart, you know, to tell him to go check his room everywhere for his backup inhaler for when he plays football. He didn't want to do it, and I just said, trust mom, okay, trust mom. And he walked back in my room holding his inhaler. He was like, you were right, mom. And so we were happy because the pharmacy was closed, so he needed that, and he's been fine ever since, praise God. Now, why do I tell y'all this story? I tell y'all this story because what if my son, God forbid, had to be like hospitalized during this? It made me think about the people who have regular ongoing hospital business in the midst of this. When I pulled up, I saw a couple, like a young Hispanic couple, get out. The husband, the young man was wearing a mask, and the young lady was not wearing a mask. And then they had what looked like a newborn baby. And I guess they're going for their 6 week or 12 week or 8 week appointment or whatever. But I was like, Don, what if you have regular, just ongoing medical stuff that you got to deal with and try to avoid coming in contact with this thing? You know what I mean? So that was kind of on my mind. So I just came here so I could pray. But I decided to reach out and just go ahead and record a video, because the thing is that to a certain degree, if you're not directly involved, meaning you're not a person working for Amazon delivering stuff, or you're not a nurse, or you're not a doctor, or you're not, you know, working in the local government or whatever, maybe you can feel like helpless, can feel like, well, it's nothing I can do. It's nothing I can do. But the reality is there's something everybody can do. Number one, of course, we can do our part to stay home unless we just gotta be out. Like I just had to step out a moment ago. Of course, one of the things we can do is we can quarantine, we can step out. But the other thing that we can do, we can pray. That's what I'm about to do. And I actually have already started, but I'm gonna pray and just stretch forth my hands and pray over this building as a representation of all facilities, and to pray over this thing. And I know we're going into like week four of this thing, and it can feel like, oh God, we're praying again. Yeah. The Bible says to pray without ceasing. The word ceasing means stop. So it says pray without stopping. So yeah, that's one thing you can do, to lend a hand. Something else you can do, if there are people in your life that have been financially impacted by this, you can be a blessing to someone else. If you know your income has not been impacted, but there are other people who can't work right now, why not sow a seed into their lives? Why not say, okay, this person does this and they can't work anymore. Let me, when I get paid, I want to bless them financially. Why not? You can do that. You can also make sure to give a little extra to your house of worship, to your church, because you know there are people that are going to be slacking and not, who are not going to the house of the Lord, so they may not give. But then you got to think about it. The house of the Lord, churches are not getting all the tithes and offering because people are not working as much. So you can give more to your church. You can give to people who you know are not working right now. You can pray. We can. I'm saying you, but I'm talking about me too. Something else, you can think about who is elderly that I know, or in I call it the valuable category, all right? Not vulnerable, but valuable. And who can I reach out to and say, hey, do you need anything? Do you need anything? Because you may have people that are kind of like, I don't really want to go out. And if they say, no, I'm all right, then that's fine. But at least you've extended yourself to say, hey, I'm running to the store. Do you need me to pick up anything and leave it outside for you? So that's something else that you can do. So, and then you can seek the Lord. God, what else can I do? I like now I'm taking more prayer walks around my neighborhood and just saying, okay, God, who else outside of my household can I pray for? Can I pray for every single home in my neighborhood? What can I do? Can I post things that are positive and uplifting and encouraging on social media? Can I sew some masks? Can I sew some masks? I see a lady from my church, Annette, sewing masks. I love that. So what can you do to be a blessing? Here's something everybody can do. Encourage somebody. Just texting people in your phone saying, hey, I just want to say, hey, do you need me to pray for you for anything? I love you. That takes nothing. So don't feel like you're paralyzed in this moment. I want you to feel immobilized. You're not paralyzed by COVID-19. I refuse. Do you hear me? I refuse to be paralyzed by this thing. I'm immobilized. That's why I preached about opportunity 3 weeks ago via YouTube Live. I'll put the link in the description if you are not familiar with what I'm talking about. This is not about focusing on, oh my God, COVID is coming, it's coming. No, 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 no. This is the opportunity time. It is, what do you want to do with me, in me, and through me during this process? I made a decision. I am going to be a better Kim Yetta at the end of this process. I'm not going to let the devil lead me astray, and I'm not going to lead myself astray or my kids or my husband or my family. I've decided I'm going to be healthier. I'm going to be stronger. I'm going to know more of the word. I'm going to be more loving. I'm going to be more productive. I'm going to have additional income streams. That's what I've decided. I've decided that I am going to be more intense, more focused, more diligent. I've decided I'm going to go down a dress size. Hallelujah. I've decided I'm going to do that. See, you have to decide. What are you going to do? Are you going to sit and keep going back and forth to the refrigerator and stand on Facebook eating quarantine snacks? I had to say, no, 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 no. See, at the end of this process, I'm going to be a better Kimyetta. And so that means I've got to do sacrificial things, which means coming, sitting in a parking lot, and praying for people I don't know, praying for people who walk by, praying for the nurses and the doctors that I see, because I want to be a better Kimyetta. I want to do what God has called me to do. But you got to get before the Lord. You got to get before the Lord and say, Lord, what would you have of me? How can I be better at the end of this? We don't know. Are we going to be done at the end of April, end of May? I was watching something with Bill Gates the other day, and his projections say we'll be done sometime in June. Well, if that's the case, what do you want June to look like for you? Do you want to be 20 pounds heavier? Not me. I'm going to be 18 pounds lighter. Watch. What do you want? Do you want to have a more word in you? Do you want to be more spiritually disciplined? What do you want? Look for the opportunities. Don't keep focused on the oddity of this. O-D-D-I-T-Y. Focus on what God says during this season and then watch them work. Hallelujah. I'm praying for y'all. I love y'all, and be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.